Hey everybody, back again. Tim, Oliver, High Noon's Vinyl, Robert Z. Lottery, question number four. You know the deal, let's go in. So, this one centers around the idea that a artist, a sculptor, if you will, has reached out to you and said, I want to make you a one-of-one, a unique piece, and what I want from you is I want the names of four vocalists who mean the most to you to put on this Mount Rushmore, if you will, of vocalists for you. They may not even be who you would consider the best of all time, but these are the four that mean the most. I mean, if you're going to put four people up there, who do you want to look at, right? Who are the ones that are going to stand out the most? And, you know, I try to take these questions as seriously as possible. I mean, you know, who? No one wants to put up Tiny Tim. So I really thought about this, and I kind of broke it up with a couple different genres. So let's get in. So, you know, my first choice probably was one of the easiest because, to me, one of my favorite all-time singers, one of my favorite rock singer is just someone who my ear gravitates towards. I've never heard them perform a bad song to me. And I'm speaking of Mr. John Anderson from Yes. There he is right there. You know, whether it be solo, whether it be with Yes, whether it be with Anderson, Bruford, Wakeman, and Howe, whatever the case may be, his voice just speaks to me. It's an incredible tone, and that man could sing the recipe to boil water. Wouldn't care, would severely enjoy it. So to me, my first choice was easy, John Anderson. So then I started thinking, you know, in the 80s, I was heavily into metal and stuff like that. So I was trying to think of, like, I wanted to represent the metal years. And I kind of had a couple names that I was thinking through. And it was tough because I could have just done an all metal one, but I wanted to, you know, these are the ones that really just rocked my socks. And maybe a popular pick for this question, I don't know. But I went with Ronnie James Dio. Ronnie James Dio to me, for someone who is like 5 foot nothing, his voice was the size of a mountain. And I've never heard a bad note from that man. Wish he was still around and cranking out the tunes. But when it came to just power, when it came to passion in the hard rock metal genre, to me, it just didn't get any better. So the next one I wanted to do was I wanted to focus on soul. And R&B and soul music is a big part of me and the music I grew up listening to and the music I still listen to. And so I looked for consistency, and there were a few names that came up. There were a few names that were hard to not mention. But they're just one name that just can't keep coming up. There were so many albums that were just too good, and too many genres crossed over that I just couldn't say no to not putting this person on the list. And that's Marvin Gaye. This is a top 10 album for me. This one is a very emotional album for me, but just a long, long line of incredible vocal performances. Again, taken from us too soon, but for me, I had to include Mr. Marvin Gaye. And then lastly, I wanted to also represent the incredible female singers there were so many that could be that I could have chosen from, and I boiled it down to two, and that one was probably the hardest. And we're not doing honorable mentions. We're not doing a, you know, if I could choose a fifth. Nope, that's not the point of this. It's to make your four. And if I had to go with a fourth, which I do, the Queen, Miss Aretha Franklin. This one was the hardest for me, I think, because while Aretha and her voice was just so amazing and was so incredibly potent and powerful, it was tough to not include somebody else, Ann Wilson from Heart, but just overall, pound for pound, there are just so many incredible moments, live moments. You know, you wanna hear an incredible performance. Listen, you know, pick up her gospel album, Amazing Grace, that was recorded live. Just it defies anything that I've ever heard. So I had to include the Queen because this is truly where, for me, this is the benchmark for. If you think you can take on Aretha, you got something. And there's a lot of female vocalists who are amazing at what they do. But this is the top. So that would be my Mount Rushmore of vocalists. All right, another question down. Several more to go. Let's keep crushing them. Love you all.